Let's think of a spiral, just a simple spiral shape. What do we associate with it? For some of us, it's the Milky Way. For others, it's a whirlpool. For those of you who are still hungry, it could mean a nice hot jalebi. And for others, it could even mean kachua chhap, the mosquito coil. We see that a single image has the power to evoke so many associations. We draw from our visual vocabulary and make those connections. All it took just now was a simple drawing. And I think this simplicity has enormous power in the way we communicate. All of us communicate to express a feeling or to convey information, and we do so typically in the form of telling stories. How impactful these stories are depend on how appealing or interesting we make them. And I think simplicity has a huge role to play in this aspect. I started drawing comics a few years ago, just on a whim. I used stick figures, a very simple visual tool used by children, adults, scientists, even business people in presentations. I think what makes a stick figure so relatable is that it's just a human being. It comes without the baggage of identity. It is completely nondescript, and you can use that to your advantage. You can mold it into any character you want. A stick figure is also a broken down form, which is a powerful way of reaching out to a human brain that's already looking to break down information. But it's also about the sheer joy and fun of what you can do with stick figures. You can make them dance. You can make them go on camel rides. You can use them to represent family members. That's my mom asking me to eat something before the world ends. You can make it do all the yoga poses that you can't. And of course, you can even make them fall in love. Here, there's an expectations mismatch. What I've learned over the years is that simplicity doesn't mean dumbing down things, but using minimalism to make your story stronger. Minimalism is about purposeful subtraction, not accidental omission. It's not about forgetting to notice something or not noticing something. It's about noticing and observing everything and then consciously choosing what to leave out. The reason I think this works so well is because in a world where there's so much information clutter, there are things swiveling on screens. If you've seen the news screens of late, there are like so many things happening there. Things are jumping out at you from websites. Perhaps all of us are subconsciously looking for that white space, that relief. A few lines can convey volumes. Everything can be broken down into simpler forms without diluting the meaning, but instead intensifying it. Simplicity can be expressed not just in how you present, but also in your content. How we experience life affects how we express it. For example, when I look back on my own childhood, it's the small, simple things that stand out. For example, my mom drawing smileys on dosas long before emojis came into existence. Or my neighbor's dog, who was always happy to see me. When I started incorporating these tiny little things into my stories, I found that they were much more relatable, and it made a better connect with the reader. There are these simple little things that connect us all, such as the joy of eating mangoes. Believe me, this is the best way to do it. The thrill of bike rides, always good to be a pillion rider. The joy of having that hot cup of chai when it's raining outside, which I think a lot of you people in Pune must be doing right now. The thrill of having cooked something really, really delicious. And this is something all of us might agree with, the relief of climbing into your bed after a long, hard day at work. In all these images, we're not only using simple lines to describe an activity, but also convey and evoke an emotion. So I think the tiniest line has the power to convey something. Even a dot has meaning. So when you use a less is more approach, the less you say, the more impactful it has to be. And which is why I try to get away with a silent TEDx talk, but life is hard. So here's an image of a sad person looking at a tree. This is exactly how I feel when I see tree stumps. And I think this is far more effective than presenting facts and figures about why we shouldn't cut trees. Here's a simple image that captures the essence of traveling by trains in India, especially by sleeper coach and especially on the window seat. Here's an image that represents the Kerala boat race, where all the boatmen are basically just one continuous squiggle. What's the easiest way to remind someone of their childhood? All of us would have done this at some point of time or would have seen other kids doing this. And this image evokes a feeling of nostalgia and not more than maybe about 10 lines. I also work with individuals to break down their life stories into comic books. So I typically have, I tell people, tell me a story, I draw it for you. And then I have somebody's entire timeline, 30 years, 40 years, 50 years, where they were born, where they went to school, different cities they've lived in. And that has taught me to break down all this information and condense it into these small, relatable visuals. How can we benefit from these simple visuals? Can we use them for positive impact? So last year, I drew a comic about women empowerment. This is just a part of a larger comic. You can see that even though these are stick figures, it represents a diverse group of people coming together. So this comic resonated with a lot of women worldwide. I had people, teachers write in to me asking me for frames for their school walls. I had also done a comic about loneliness, how to deal with loneliness and depression. And there was a teenager who wrote in to me saying that the comic gave him hope. This kind of feedback has made me realize that even though these are very simple images, you can really tap into their potential for positive impact. Let's look at an issue such as environmental conservation. Here I've compared the life on planet Earth to the heartbeat on an ECG graph. And I think all of us would agree that we never want to see it become a straight line. All of us know that when we incorporate a physical activity into our daily routines, we start to feel really empowered. You know what they say about running, you put one foot in front of the other and you feel you can overcome anything. So this visual was an attempt to capture that. So here's, we can also talk about things like body shaming, which is relevant to our times today. Here the comic says, woman, you owe it to nobody to fit into a size or succumb to a shape. So I've used differently sized and differently shaped pots to represent that no matter what your outward appearance or your external form, you still have the capacity to blossom. All of us have been through this existential crisis where we're like, what is the meaning of all this? And what is the purpose of life? I need to figure this out. But I think one of the easiest way to solve that problem is to create your own meaning or create your own solutions. So here we have a person looking at a box thinking, you know, what does this mean, trying to get inside and, you know, do all these things. But ultimately, he draws a perfectly solved Rubik's Cube, something that all of us aspire to do. All of us resist change. I'm completely averse to change. But I've learned that if you just be in the moment and if you just relax, good things happen to you. This was something that was done for a magazine on entrepreneurship. So typically when you tell someone you want to do something, especially if it's unconventional, they say, hey, what's your plan? What's your backup plan? What are your options? Where's your Excel sheet? But I think that if you really, really want to do something, you will go out there and get it. So this comic was about that. We can also talk about more serious issues, such as how we're becoming less and less of a diverse, inclusive society. So here we have like these diverse characters all hanging out together, having fun. And then we're saying, hey, you look different, so you go in this box. You look different, so you go in this box. So that is very, very relevant to our times today. Almost all our news headlines revolve around something that stems from this. So this is, people who have read a lot about evolution will obviously disagree with me, but let's just say that this is a science-defying comic. So we've got something to learn from giraffes here. So when you want something really, really badly, we all know about the law of attraction. The entire universe comes onto your side and makes it happen for you. Thank you. One of the best things about illustration is how you can remind people of the little wonderful things that we are surrounded by in our daily lives. I experienced my first autumn abroad last year, and I was completely mesmerized by the colors. This illustration was an attempt to capture that. I'm also working with an organization against the use of plastic bags. So typically when we talk about plastic bags, we have a lot of statistics about how they're harming the environment, killing a lot of ocean life. But what we decided to do is to have an entire series of comics where we have a stick man traveling the world with his son, and he tries to save these animals from the dangers of plastic bags. So here we have a whale that's about to swallow a plastic bag, which it mistakes for jellyfish. And the stick man's trying to, discourage it from doing so. I've worked with various individuals and organizations worldwide, and I've realized that everyone's seeking the same thing. Everyone wants to be able to tell their stories in a way that is effective and memorable. So I worked in collaboration with a business school last year, where we converted a complex business case study into a comic book. And students typically dread studying these text-heavy business case studies, which are about like 40 pages, 100 pages long. And we converted it into an almost doodle format, a 16-page book. And the professors found that the students were a lot more engaged and responsive when they were given the case study in this format. So going forward, I'd like to explore how these stick figures and how these simple visuals can be used not just to entertain, but also educate. Can they be used as visual aids in schools? A lot of schools are using them already, to explain difficult concepts in, say, physics. Can they be used to teach children history, where you can have like an entire stick figure timeline? Can they be used to encourage children to overcome the fear of self-expression by encouraging them to draw? Everyone can draw a stick figure. Can they be used to bridge language barriers in a country as diverse as India, where we have people who can read and write different languages, many people who can't read or write? Because I think everyone has some sort of a universal visual vocabulary that we understand. So these are some of the things I'd like to explore going forward. So why does this work so well? So whereas a line has the power to convey so much, I think a missing line also has equal power, if not more, to convey something. By simplifying your information, you are removing distractions and noise from an image. You are removing distractions from your words and making your message crystal clear. It's very unlikely that somebody is going to forget it. The theme of this event is unraveling the spirit in us to embrace change, the only constant. But I think in the face of so much change, there's one thing that has remained constant for many, many years. And that's the power of something as simple as caveman drawings to be able to tell a story, make a connect, and inspire thought and action. Thank you.